All right, guys, quick video on two tragedies that happened this weekend. One in New York and one in Texas. There was a situation where a man, he was in a church in Texas, and I think it's Tarrant County, Texas, and they were actually live, actually streaming the service. It was a small church. They were actually streaming it, broadcasting it or whatever, and this guy, the assailant, had on a large coat, and he was sitting towards the back of the church. And you can see the whole thing play out on video. The guy got up, and he pulled out a shotgun, what appeared to be a shotgun from his coat. Another guy stood up, and he was actually pointing at one person. Then the guy next to him actually went to draw his gun, and he got shot. I believe he was the one who was killed by his assailant. And then there are other people in the church who stood up to this guy. There are other people with guns. They had to shoot this guy. They had to kill this guy. And fortunately, the situation wasn't even worse. The perpetrator wasn't able to kill more people, wasn't able to harm more people. At one point, this guy, this elderly man, actually covered up his wife. He was trying to shield her from any type of gunfire. And I just want to talk about this because this highlights something that we in the gun community have talked about for the longest. Evil people are going to always exist. They're always going to do things. They're always going to try to harm others. But what's really important is how we respond to this. And in this church, these people responded to it. One guy actually got killed trying to stop this guy, but the other people in that church were armed. They were able to stop this guy. And it just shows, no matter what evil people do, it's our response. A good guy with a gun can make a huge difference. A good guy, period. In New York, These Jewish people were under attack. This rabbi, he was having some type of social gathering or whatever. And this guy is a black male. That's all I know about him. 38 years old. He walked into there with a machete and he started cutting and stabbing people. I think he stabbed five people. One person still in critical condition. He exited the house and one person followed the guy out. And this person actually wrote down the guy's license plate as an assailant drove away. Actually wrote down the license plate. That's what I mean. Whether you have a gun or not, a good guy, a person who's willing to do the right thing can make all the difference in the world. And this is why I talk about prepping. This is why I talk about this stuff. Because, yeah, bad things are going to happen. You know, there could be a natural disaster. There could be a terrorist attack. There could be this and that. You know, the question, we can't control everything, but we should look at what we can control and how we can make the situation better. And in these situations, even though they happen in two very different places, two very different situations, the governor of New York called that attack on the rabbi and his guests, act of domestic terrorism. The fact of the matter is, good guys did step up, and that's something we should all keep in mind. That's something we spend too much time focusing on the bad guys, but not enough on good people who do the right thing and actually stand up to these bad guys. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.